And right now, there's nobody really logged on, but they could see it later. So, hi, Modi.
How are you, Victoria?
I'm good. You like my filter with my bling on my eyes?
Yes, very nice. Very drag queeny, actually. No, it's like I'm watching RuPaul.
Oh, shit. All right, so maybe I should change it. All right.
No, it's actually very nice.
Okay, I'll keep it. So, you're Jewish, right?
No, I just play one on Instagram.
That's how I discovered you. You were on Elon Gold's Instagram, and you were advertising that you guys were going to be at the Stand Up New York, which I saw and I loved. I don't know if
Yeah.
anybody else saw you guys on this Instagram, but you were fantastic. Anyway, you went on as a Hasidic guy, and I was like, I didn't make the connection that you were also on Crashing because I saw Crashing. I was living in Hawaii at the time,
Oh,
and
really?
that was the only outlet. Yeah, I lived in Hawaii for 6 years. So I'm kind of like new to the New York comedy scene, but the only thing I had going was Crashing at the time. So I'm like, oh my God, that's like my only outlet. So now I go to the Olive Tree all the time and I eat dinner there.
Well, that
Because of
makes
that
you a
show.
comic. What?
No, that doesn't make me a comic. I
No.
started in comedy a long time ago, but I never really pursued it until now.
Good. Good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen you at the Comedy Cellar once in a while. That's how I know you.
Yeah. And Elon and I have a mutual friend, Oz Perlman, who's also going to be on the show.
The mentalist, right? Something like that. I've worked with him many times. Very nice guy.
Yeah, he and my husband are very good friends. They're both ultra runners, so they run a lot.
Good, good.
So basically, how you holding up? Where are you now, in New York?
I'm home writing material, doing a lot of Instagram posts, and just doing a joke a day on Instagram, which seems to be what my audience is really enjoying. Once in a while,
They
I go
love
on
it.
as a character, having a lot of fun with it, making the best of it, exercising, watching what I eat. I've been able to do that intermittent fasting now that I don't have to be at a dinner every night or out at a club every night. And I don't know. I'm okay for a minute. I'm okay. I mean, I'm definitely missing the stage and looking to get back on it, but taking a good breath here.
Are you going
Yeah.
to get more? Is this going to create something that's going to be like your new normal, where you're going to be more, productive at home and do some more balance? Do you think
I think
that?
so. I didn't. Yeah, I think so. I'm definitely enjoying my home a lot more than I have in the past, and I like the routine. I like the waking up and not running out and not. It's look in 30 days. Who knows what the hell is going to be? I might want to just run, jump out the window. But as of now, I'm making making the best of it. I couldn't be happier.
That's great. That's great. When did you get started in comedy? When, what, like, how old were you? Or was it always?
It was 25 years ago. 25 years ago was the first spot I ever was given at the Comedy Cellar. So that's when when I began comedy.
I see. Yeah, you're nobody until you do the seller. I see. No.
It's just an easier time to remember. I had spots before, open mic here, open mic there, but when I got past at the Comedy Cellar, I go, this is when I'll start to say.
Wow.
Yeah.
How long did that take? I mean, I'm wondering because I'm probably gonna have a walker by the time I get on that stage. So I'm just wondering
We'll build a ramp for you there.
I'll need one. What how long did you do it before that? Because I'm
I
wondering
was a
because some people
year,
think
I was only
that
a year and a half in. I was only a year and a half
no.
in. Yeah, but when I began, I was super over the top with these crazy characters and like Fifth Gear energy, and Esty saw it and loved it, and then I hosted a lot, and that was back in 94. Yeah.
Wow. Are you always friends with Elon Gold?
Yeah, we went to college together actually, but back then I had no idea I wanted to be a comedian. But
And he did?
he did, and he's always doing comedy, so he's got a few more years on me, but we were friends back then, and now we're very, very close friends. Yeah.
Did you get inspired by anybody like Jackie Mason, all those types of comedians? Is that what got you into it?
I got inspired by a friend of mine made me do comedy. He said, you're very funny. You should, at the table, you should be funny on stage. And that's how it started. And then my comics that I always looked at were old school comedians like Alan King and those types of comedians. If you, I don't know if you know that, but yes, the Jackie Mason's a genius in his own right, you know. Yeah,
I'm 50 years old. I know a lot of them, but okay. I'm actually friends with Jackie.
You look much younger than 50.
It's the filter. I'm actually friends with Jackie Mason.
Oh yeah, yes. You're a woman interested in comedy. That would definitely put you in the lead to speak with Jack.
I get a phone call from him once a week.
That's wonderful. Yeah. I love him. He's, I had about a year or so ago, he was at Stand Up New York for something, and I did like a 45-minute set in front of him. It was like, I want to say it was one of the highlights of my, it was a highlight of my career, because just to work in front of like the king of what I do, you know?
Wow, that is amazing.
And he was like, huh?
You talked to him afterwards, right?
Yeah, we spoke afterwards, and he was, and he was very, very sweet, and he enjoyed it, and he was, like, very funny, and I even did some singing stuff, which he used to do in his show, and he was, amazing genius talent. Amazing.
Yeah, well, you have it, too. Definitely. There's no question. I mean, I don't run to comedy clubs because I run 4 open mics and I also produce shows, which I'd love to have you on. But anyway, I ended up running to the Stand Up New York that night, and I watched you and Elon, and I was just like on the floor. I was dying. I mean, the whole place was Jewish. I even met a few people there that were friends today on Instagram, but they even came to my show afterwards. But it was a joy to see somebody like also from, you know, where did you grow up? Did you grow up in New York?
I was born in Israel. I grew up in the Five Towns of Long Island. Yeah.
Oh, really? My mother lives in Tel Aviv right now.
Oh, okay. I was just there right before this whole thing started. I was in Israel and then Florida and then back home. And I landed just when it, like everybody said, get in your houses and lock it up.
Wow. You just need it. Do you wish you were in Israel, by the way, if you were at lockdown?
No, I couldn't be happy. If I'm being quarantined, this is where I want to do it. My apartment, I don't want to be in some buddy's house up in the mountains or anything. I'm good the way it is right now. Yeah.
You go out every single day? Do you go for a walk? I go to Central Park every day.
To be honest, it's been about 3 days since I did step out of the apartment, but I've been doing a lot of exercising in the apartment, so I feel that makes it up. I don't know. I feel like there's just corona in the air, so I just feel like if I don't need to step outside and I'm getting exercise inside, it's fine with me, yeah. I mean, we're in New York. I don't have the news on, ever.
Okay, so good.
I catch a headline here or there just to make sure, like, the cure, don't get online for the cure. I don't want to miss that headline. But so I don't really know what's going on, but I get phone calls. Oh my God, you're in New York. What's going on? Are you alive? I'm like, is it that bad? I don't know.
Well, I mean, between the Me Too movement and Three's a Crowd, I don't know what the new normal is going to be, but not everybody's going to be jumping out of their seats to get outside either. I mean, there are going to be those that are running out, and there's going to be others that are just like, I'm not ready yet. I don't know how it's going to go.
They're going to go very fast out. You'll see.
You think so?
Yeah. This will clear up a little bit. It's gonna be a little bad. You know, the curve is gonna be, this week is gonna suck. This week is gonna suck, especially for people who are watching the news. It's gonna be.
We had a little blip.
Those who are, and then it's gonna get a little bit better, and then it'll go. It'll taper off, and restaurants will start opening. I've been listening to things happening in Beijing. And they're saying that, like, restaurants are opening up now over there. So
It took three months.
Yeah. But it took one hard month of, like, really. Yeah. Yeah.
So, I mean, I think I might have had it in January. Nobody could diagnose it. So
everybody's maybe like, oh, yeah, I stubbed my toe that day and I had it. Everybody thinks
I know. All comics are thinking that's hack. It's not. I'm really serious. Like, I truly, truly think I had it in January, because what happened was I ended up having this thing. It was a flu. I was sure of it. They're like, it's not a flu. I'm like, what is it? And then I had this cough, and it was a dry cough for 2 months. It wouldn't go away. I begged them for an x-ray. They gave me an x-ray. They said it was clear. Nothing was, they couldn't diagnose it. I had a high fever. I had every symptom that you're talking about now for the coronavirus, but nobody could diagnose it. Four different doctors. I finally got prednisone, a steroid, and the cough went away. So,
really?
Yeah, I mean, you don't know when it exactly came. Maybe there was a first wave and we built antibodies and then there was a new
could
strain.
Be, yeah.
You don't
and
know.
There's going to be a whole, what's it called, the immune herd, like immunity herd, the people who have already had it, now they're able to function, so...
Yeah, yeah, and give their blood for other people's blood so that
right,
they can have
right.
antibodies, which is great.
Right.
Are you wearing pants?
Am I what? Am I wearing
what? I ask this to everybody. Are you wearing pants?
Absolutely not. I have found a pair of underwear. I have found a pair of underwear that I love, and I ordered a whole bunch of them, and I wear only them. And they're like a little long, so it keeps between the thighs, and it's an amazing, and they're not expensive either. Usually my underwear is like super expensive. These are like so amazing that I can't get over them. So I wear only them.
Are they sponsoring you? You want to plug
what?
Them? Are they sponsoring you, or do you want to plug them? Are they sponsoring you?
No, they're not. So I was, and to be honest with you, I was in, where was I? It's a Target or Walmart, someplace I'd never been to in my life. And they have... they have clothing sections there. Did you know that?
Yes. I'm a mother of three. I know that.
I had like a 20-pack of underwear, Champion underwear. It was good. So like I bought them and they fit. Oh, my nuts are in heaven. Heaven. Holds the nuts nice. I walk in the house. There's no chafing. Ass is good in them. So I've been, that's what I just basically wear.
I'm loving elastic right now because none of my pants fit. But what was I going to say? So, do you have any other hobbies besides like comedy or any of the jobs? Are you getting
comedy? Comedy is not my hobby. It is how it.
No, that's not what I meant.
The mortgage and the payments. It's far from a hobby.
No, that's not what I meant.
Yes.
I meant, do you have any hobbies and do you have any other jobs? Any other any type of other job?
No, I don't have any. Comedy, a stand-up comic is what I am in all aspects. There's no other jobs. And hobby-wise, you know, exercising, I think it's a hobby. And it's more than a hobby. It's an essential. So
yeah, I agree.
I do miss the gym a lot. I will say that much, yes. But I'm having an amazing time on the Nike Training Club. NTC, it's very good. So I'm
really?
Plugging things that are not sponsoring me. But for the 24 people that are listening, I guess it's not like I'm missing something out.
Well, some you know, a lot of people might watch this later too. It goes on
okay.
The stories.
Oh, that's
but,
right. You put it back on. Right.
Yeah, not everybody's around right now or paying attention
so
right now.
You tape it and you put it on. I gotcha.
Yeah.
Very good.
So is there anything you want to talk about or, you know, want to plug or anything besides your underwear and
your... No, I don't know. I'm really enjoying all the comments people put. So every day now I put a joke online and you know, just put one joke, like a regular Jewish joke, nothing, you know,
like a
man and a wife, that kind of joke. And then I do this character that's amazing. And, so go to the website and let me know what you think of the jokes. If you have any jokes you want to have me say, if it's a good joke, I'll do
really?
It. Yeah.
You didn't write all those jokes or you did write all those jokes?
Those are like, some of them I put together, but most of them are like old school, you know, old school jokes, which are just people. It's a joke that the reason I did it is because not only can they remember it, it reminds them, but then they can tell it to somebody else. So in the middle of all this corona, people can at least say, hey, you want to hear a good joke? And they have a joke, you know? So now
anybody else in your family funny?
Everybody in my family is, my dad's very funny, very
really?
unedited. So that becomes funny. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
He must be so proud of you.
Yeah, he's very proud. Yeah. Yeah, they're happy. Thank God they're behaving themselves with this coronavirus. They're staying home. We're going to do a Zoom Seder, which is a thing now.
Oh, yeah, I was going to ask you about the Seder before you got off. Yeah,
yeah,
it's a Zoom Seder. Okay. Are they Orthodox?
If we're doing a Zoom study, we're not Orthodox, but we're good. We're like, we're our own thing, more traditional. I like that word, traditional.
Yeah, that's what I am. I grew up in Brooklyn. I'm Sephardic. I went to Flatbush Yeshiva.
Oh, you did? Oh, yeah?
Yeah,
you're
and Syrian. I would have stayed.
Are you Syrian?
Yeah, I'm Syrian.
Oh, you're Syrian. Very good.
I was the only Syrian in Hawaii for 6 years, but
What were you doing in Hawaii for 6 years?
My husband is Ashkenaz, and we were living in Westchester.
Someone just wrote something very funny. Someone just wrote,